Solar Challenge itself is a distance-based event. Independence, Missouri to Twin Falls, Idaho.
They're off.
Teams that just scrape by, the best teams, because they've had to struggle and fight, learn, and do all of it on their own skin.
We're going to have to replace 75 solar cells.
So, it's teamwork.
On day one of the American Solar Challenge, every team that attempted the first challenge loop failed and lost valuable time reaching their checkpoint. A grim prospect faced Iowa State University.
Yeah, so we've been having lots of issues. Our motors were not operating like they should have been. They were drawing a lot more current, and they weren't moving nearly as fast for the amount of throttle we were putting in.
Less than 5 miles into the race, their car breaks down, freezing them out of the MOV competition. Their chances of any comeback are slim. After a sleepless night, Principia manages to get their car up and running. The race between first and second could not be any closer.
Just drop the battery.
I can replace you.
Okay, yeah. Cool.
Yeah, sentiment that we're just gonna power through. Oh, couple of all-nighters, some 2 a.m.s, and then there's early morning starts. When you break one cell in the back, you lose the whole segment. We lost more than a third of our range, is our driving power and charging power.
But this car wouldn't be here without her. She's critical to this operation.
I'm really impressed with the midnight fairies who make it all right again by the next morning.
Today, excellence is the key. The car is working perfectly fine now. I got the nerves going.
Okay, good. Thank you.
But it's because I'm excited.
Stage one's rocky journey behind them, teams are pinning their hopes on a smooth ride towards stage two.
My name is Carol Clark. I'm a park ranger with the National Park Service, and I work with National Historic Trails. There is the car that's going, but there's also all of the support. I have not visited national parks, not seen America. They find a way to connect and see it from a new perspective. So they will see the backdrop of really iconic America, Chimney Rocks, God's Bluff, and it's introducing to them the possibility of the future. Where do you yourself want to go? And one way to figure that out is following a route like a National Historic Trail.
Most have their eyes glued to the next challenge loop. This 21-mile track is much more attainable than the last.
Would you like to get out of the car?
Thanks to a 15-minute mandatory hold required between each loop, a quick solar array recharge adds fuel to the tank. The race remains neck and neck for Principia and MIT. They each succeed in driving 6 challenge loops for a bonus 126 miles added to their final tally. Kentucky and Illinois trail close behind as another sunset closes out the day. With over 300 miles to Garing, Nebraska, open roads provide ample opportunities to clock up points. Now rested at the foot of Scott's Bluff National Monument, many teams have found their groove.
So right here you're standing at Scott's Bluff National Monument, which trail is actually just right directly behind us here, just beyond this last wagon. That actually is the exact same trail the wagons went through in the Western Expansion. You can walk it and be a part of history.
This is the lifesaver. This is the thing that you put around your neck and it helps you float as you drive the car. We'll demonstrate.
Look at that.
Just straight under.
And then
pregnant. The best part, whenever there's a downhill, you forget about the heat.
Nope.
Because you're and you're like, oh, that was sick. And then 5 minutes later, you're driving straight again, you're like, oh, yeah, it's on.
Yeah.
One of my goals this summer is to be able to learn how to deal with failure, because there's just so many times, there's so many opportunities for failure, and you just gotta learn how to move forward.
So the past couple of races, our team strategy has been go fast, get as far as we can. We're just trying to give ourselves as much of a buffer as far as reaching that target average speed of 35 miles per hour. We're expecting that the hills will slow us down quite a bit. It'll just take us a long time to climb them. We've been trying to build up as much of a buffer as possible.
Dale Green ahead.
With its slogan, "Where rails end and trails begin," Lander, Wyoming became the final stop of the Old West Cowboy Line. Generations of these covered wagons have paved the way for their solar successors to go the distance.
Yeah, I tried to drive as efficiently as possible while going still fast. We still have a good amount in the battery pack, and yeah, just a bunch of loops today then. Tried to keep up with MIT.
Woo, Chris, you broke the solar record. You got 930 watts.
An additional 156 miles take the solar cars into the land of bison and meadow larks.
Inspector to Esteban.
Esteban, copy.
Good luck out there. That looks like a safe setup for your caravan. Good luck.
Principia lead. MIT wishes to pass you to close the gap between solar and lead. Semi passing on your left, semi truck on the left.
At the last challenge loop of stage two, MIT edges ahead of Principia with one extra loop of 33.4 miles. As day six of the Odyssey approaches, each team is no less than hyper-aware of the challenges ahead, succeeding and failing at the highest level. But with two more stages to go, their minds remain on active overdrive.